गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टेक आउट पेज नंबर 145। नाउ वी शैल कंटिन्यू विद द लेसन द डायमंड नेकलेस। सो एज यू कैन रिमेम्बर दैट मैटिल्डा एंड हर हस्बैंड लॉसल हैड गॉन टू अ पार्टी। सो एट द पार्टी मैटिल्डा वॉज वेरी वेरी हैप्पी बिकॉज शी हैड बीन द सेंटर ऑफ अट्रैक्शन एंड एवरीवन वॉज praising her beauty. Even the minister had praised her beauty and all men and women had noticed her and asked her name. So Matilda had been very happy because her victory had been complete, it seemed, because her beauty was incomparable to anyone. She had danced with joy. She was very triumphant because she had been the most beautiful. And she had forgotten all about her husband, who sat there all alone in the corner of the reception room. And she was only thinking about herself and had danced with joy and enthusiasm. All through the party, she had forgotten about her husband. Now, let us continue. It was about 4 in the morning when Matilda could tear herself away. So it was around 4 o'clock in the morning, 4 a.m. in the morning, when Matilda came from the party. She was so happy that she was having the perfect time. It was morning, 4 a.m. in the morning when Matilda could come away. A chilly wind was blowing. Now it was very windy and it was very cold wind which was blowing. Her husband threw around her shoulders the old shawl that they had carried with them. So it was very windy and it was very cold wind was blowing. So it was 4 a.m. in the morning. So husband gave her a shawl to cover her shoulder. And it was her old shawl which they had carried. So it was old shawl that she used. They had to walk some distance before they could get a cab. So, from the party as they came out, they had to walk some distance. And it was cold and chilly wind was blowing. So, they had to walk some distance. Then they got a taxi or a cab. The cab took them to their place. So, that cab they hired to take them to the place where they were staying. Gloomily, they climbed the stairs to their flat. So they appeared very gloomy, very sad as they went up the stairs to their flat. So it was all over for Matilda. So the great occasion of the party and all the enjoyment, all the fun was over. So for Matilda, it was the end of a very great day. So it was all over, all the merriment, all the fun, it was over. So Matilda was very sad. She removed the shawl from her shoulders and stood before the glass to have a final view of her glory. So, for Matilda, it was all over. The perfect day had ended. And she removed the shawl over her shoulders, which was over her shoulders, and stood before the mirror to have a final look at her glory or her perfect moment. Suddenly, she gave a cry. As she stood looking at herself in the mirror to remember the perfect moment she had, she cried out, why? Her necklace was not around her neck. So as she looked at herself in the mirror, her final view, she had to found that she was no longer wearing her necklace. The necklace was not there. So the necklace that she had borrowed from her friend, Mrs. Forrester, the diamond necklace which she had worn, it was no longer there around her neck. So she gave out a cry. She was very much upset. So she gave a cry. So the necklace was not there. What is the matter? Asked Lossel. Her husband asked her, what was the matter? Forrester's necklace, I don't have it. So she said that it seems I have lost the necklace. Mrs. Forrester's necklace, I don't have it anymore. The necklace is not around my neck.
So it seems I have lost this. What? How is that? It is not possible. So nurses said, how can it happen? How did it happen? It is not possible. You had it. So how can it be possible? How could you have lost it? They look at the folds of the dress. So they began searching for the necklace in the folds of her dress, in the pockets and everywhere. So they searched for the necklace in the folds of her beautiful dress, in the pockets and everywhere they looked for the necklace. But they could not find the necklace. Though they searched for the necklace, they could not find the necklace anywhere. They searched it in the folds of her dress, in the pockets and everywhere, but they could not find it. You are sure you had it when you left the party? Asked Lausel. So Lausel asked Matilda that, are you sure you had it when you left the party? So are you sure you had worn the necklace when you had left the party? Yes, I felt it as we came out. So Matilda said, yes, I'm sure I had it because I could feel it on my neck when we had come out of the party. So, but if it had fallen in the street, you should have heard it. It must have dropped in the cab. So Lawson said, if you had the necklace on when you came out of the party, if it had fallen in the street, you would have heard the sound. You would have heard the sound. And if it had fallen anywhere else, you could have heard it. So you must have dropped it in the cab or in the taxi, because in the street it would have made a noise. If it had fallen from the neck in the street, it would have made a noise, and you must have dropped it in the cab. So Lausel was very much upset. Both of them were very upset that the necklace was lost. Yes, it is possible. So Lawson said it must be that she had lost it or dropped it in the cab. So Matilda said, yes, it is very likely. It is very much possible. Did you take the number? No, do you have the number of the cab? No. And you? No. So do you have the number of the cab? So Lawson said, no. And Lawson asked Matilda, do you have the number of the cab? So both of them did not have the number of the cab. So now the expensive necklace, the diamond necklace that Matilda had borrowed for the party, had been lost. And it might have fallen in the street, or they must have lost it in the cab. So both Lawson and Matilda did not have the number of the cab. So it was possible that it may have been lost in the cab. And both of them were very sad because the expensive necklace had been lost. So we'll stop here for today. Thank you.